now we discuss that what is caste system. So caste system is a system in which castes are places above or below. Some castes are placed in the society like a ladder. Here you can see it is a ladder in which, you know, lower caste is placed below and the upper caste is placed above. That means this is a system in which castes are placed. Some castes are placed very below, which are called as lower caste, and the other name for lower caste is untouchables or Dalit. And some castes are placed in the above, which are known as upper caste. So the person or people who belong to upper caste, they think that they are superior, and their mindset for the lower caste people is that they are inferior. So the caste system is the main reason behind, you know, discrimination against the people when we judge the people on the basis of work they perform. So according to this, when we place different caste in different, you know, criteria, then there remain some caste rules. Some caste rules are there, that those persons who belong to lower caste have to perform those activities which are not performed by the upper caste. For example, the lower caste people are, you know, forced. They are forced to perform the activities like picking up garbage. Picking up garbage. As they have a mindset that those persons who belong to lower caste are not supposed to perform managerial activities. So this is a discrimination in the society when, according to caste, we assign the task, we assign the work that if you belong to a lower caste, you are supposed to perform picking up of a garbage. So according to the caste system, this practice is followed in a society when people are categorized in two castes. First one is for upper caste. So better work opportunities are provided for the person who belong to a upper caste, and, you know, very negligible opportunities for jobs are provided for those who belongs to lower caste. As same happened with the people, with the children who are in the schools, that if a child who belongs to a lower caste, he is not supposed to sit with the children who belongs to upper caste. So this also prevail a discrimination in the school also, that there is a distribution of students on the basis of caste. Another example that we can take, that in villages, the lower caste people are not supposed to enter in the temples, or they are not allowed to use the well for drinking purpose. So all these criteria are set according to caste system. If any person who belongs to a lower caste does not want to perform the task which is assigned to them by the upper caste, he is always considered to be that if he belongs to a lower caste, he have to perform this task. Either that person, you know, is educationally well qualified, professionally well qualified, but the mentality or the negativity of the person always remain that if a person is belong to a lower caste, he must perform those activities which are not meant for the upper caste. So this system is there, the caste system is there, which is main reason behind, you know, distributing the different caste and assigning the work to the different caste. So the main issue that lead to as we came to know about the story of B.R. Ambedkar, he also, you know, share his story with all of us, that when he was 9 years old, he also faces this problem of discrimination according to caste. So we will discuss about the story of B.R. Ambedkar. So now we discuss some facts about Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So the full name of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was Bhim Rao Ramji Ambedkar. He was born in 1891 and his death anniversary is in 1956. Then Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is also known as the father of Indian Constitution, as we all know that the Indian Constitution has been written by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So that's why the other name which is given to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is the father of Constitution. Then Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was a leader for Dalit. As we know that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar belongs to a Dalit community, so he became the leader of Dalit because Dr. B.R. Ambedkar fought for the rights of Dalit. As we know that Dalits are not allowed to enter in the temple, so Dr. B.R. Ambedkar fought for the Dalit so that they also get the equal right in the society, and the entry which was banned by the other society, other upper caste people. So that's why Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is known as the leaders of Dalit. As he fought for the Dalit community, for their entry in temples. Then Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the first person who completed his education from the college and went to England for becoming a lawyer. So this was about Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. As we know that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar also belongs to a lower caste, and we discussed earlier that if a person who belongs to a lower caste, he is not supposed to get knowledge, he is not supposed to do a managerial activity or, you know, any activity which is related to higher post. But Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, you know, after all these stereotypes and after all the negative opinion of different people, he just want to complete his education. He want to become something in the society, as he knows that the only thing which provide respect is knowledge, is education. So Dr. B.R. Ambedkar also tried to encourage Dalits that if you want an equal respect in the society, you all have to get education, you all have to get knowledge, because according to him, knowledge is the power. The only power that prevails in the society is knowledge. If you don't have enough money, if you don't have enough resources, all things came into a different category. But if you have a knowledge, if you have a perfect knowledge, then you will get respect in the society. As he also came to know that after getting education and becoming a lawyer, he get, you know, respect in the society. As he want that the same respect should be given to all the Dalit members, because this is not necessary that if a person who belong to a, you know, Dalit community, he is not supposed to do, you know, high position tasks. But according to mentality and negative opinion of the people in the society, they felt that if a person who belong to a lower caste, he is not supposed to take education. So this was about Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So in later in his life, he, you know, converted into Buddhism. He converted his religion into Buddhism. He converted because, as Hindu, he faces, you know, a discrimination on the basis of his caste. So late in his life, he converted himself, his religion from Hindu to Buddhism. Because in Buddhism we find that equal respect for each and every citizen. So that's why the main reason of converting himself from Hindu to Buddhism was that, as he was Hindu, he always faces a discrimination in the society, because according to people's mindset, they always felt that he belongs to a, you know, lower caste, or he belongs to a Dalit community. So Dr. B.R. Ambedkar has, you know, shared his experience that when he was 9 years old, he was, you know, accompanied by his brother and cousins to meet his father in Koregaon. So he went there and he was sitting on the railway station and, you know, waiting for his father. So there one station master, you know, was passing there. So he came near to the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who was just 9 years old. From the, you know, appearance, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was looking like that he belongs to a Brahmin community. So the station master, you know, went forward to him and asked him that, why are you sitting here and for whom you are waiting for? So he asked that, I am waiting for my father. I think that he was late and we were waiting here, that he will send someone who can, pick up us and send us to his father. So when they were talking with each other, the station master asked that, from which community do you belong? And he asked that, I belong to a Dalit community. So suddenly the reaction of station master was changed. Earlier, who was talking very politely and very lovingly, started, you know, thinking that the boy belonged to a community which are known as untouchable. So this boy will pollute the environment, and, you know, who was standing in front of that boy just stepped back. So here we can see that, you know, a person, when he does not know that from which community that boy belongs, at that time he was very, you know, lovingly and caring nature shown by that station master. But when he came to know that the boy belonged to a, you know, lower caste, suddenly his reaction changed. So he asked the station master that, we want to go, you know, Koregaon, can we get any block card from this place? So as this news was, you know, flown in all the area that the boy who was sitting in the station, so he belongs to a lower caste. So all the block cards, those who were there with block cards, they all refused to take the boy to the place he wanted to go, as the boy, means Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, was ready to pay double amount, double charges, double fare. But nobody was there to allow their block cards so that the boy is, you know, taken to the place where he wants to. So here Dr. B.R. Ambedkar also faces the discrimination. When he was just 9 years old, he came to know that in a society, if someone belongs to a lower caste, he is not supposed to go anywhere because he does not get, you know, a respect in the society. So all these things, you know, just create a sense of, you know, dignity is being, you know, crashed in. So that's why Dalits are known as the broken people. They felt that if a person who belongs to a Dalit community, his self-respect is broken. So that was the incident which was shared by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar when he first time faces the problem of discrimination in his life. As we know that we got independence in 1947. So at that time, the leaders were also concerned about the different inequalities which were prevailing in the society. So government was also there, who was, you know, very concerned that in the society there are different inequalities which are prevailing. So our leaders decided to have certain rules so that, you know, equality may prevail in the society. So they have made some rules. So the first rules they made was equality for all. So they made a rule that, according, as we know that when we got our independence, after, you know, 3 years, we got our constitution. So the leaders of our independent India, they also wanted to have equality in the society. So they have made certain rules in a written form of rules that are known as constitution. So the basic idea behind, you know, making these rules was that every citizen in the independent India will get equal importance in the society. So the second rule made by the leaders of independent India was untouchability is a crime. So they made that if we found anyone who was, you know, following the practice of untouchability, that is considered to be crime. And the third rule was, if equality does not prevail, government can take action. If, you know, if government found that equality is not prevailing in the society, then they have authority that they can take, you know, preventive measures so that equality may prevail in the society. So at the end, when these rules are made and we found our constitution, which was made by the Constituent Assembly and which was written by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, we have got secularism in our society. So what is secularism? Secularism is, you know, a right for us which provides that we all have a freedom to choose and practice of our religion. That means there will be no interference of the society. But whichever religion we want to choose and whatever different type of practices we want to perform under our religion, we all have a freedom to perform those activities. So these come under a secularism. When constitution was made by the Constituent Assembly, by the independent India, and who wrote this constitution, we know that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is known as the father of constitution, as personally he has faced, you know, discrimination in his life. So he wants that in a society where all of us are independent, we must all have, you know, freedom, that we can choose religion of our choice, and if we want to perform certain activities which are related to our religion, we must all have freedom to perform those activities.